Okay. So clearly you've made the best decision of your life, which is to learn MATLAB, because that's obviously the way to take over the world. Step one, learn MATLAB, and then profit. So it's amazing, and you pull this up and you're like, okay, I have no idea what's going on. There's a blinking cursor and you're like, awesome, I'm gonna type in an X, because that's what they always do on fancy TV shows. They're always like, woo, and then they're like, I found the something or other, and then they hack into the FBI. And then it's like, thanks, okay. So our first attempt at coding has failed. So let's just do something we know is correct. So we know that 1 + 1 = 2. Yay, we're kind of amazing. So something happened here. If you have something set up like this, you see over here, it says answer equals 2. So there's an answer, the answer is 2. It's pretty fantastic. Now, if you wanted to do something super amazing, you could say x equals 1 + 1. And now over here, it says x equals 2. Now answer equals 2 and x equals 2. There's like two whole things equal 2 in the universe. This is pretty amazing. This is fantastic. I don't know what else you could want in life. So you're basically done learning to program. This is like mostly all of it right now. Okay, so this is MATLAB. You type stuff here, it does stuff, and then stuff shows up here and here. It's pretty fantastic. As you're looking around, there's all kinds of buttons, and honestly, you use like almost none of them ever, unless you're like super fancy and into it. Let's see, what can we type that's kind of fun? So if you just want to kind of do something at the beginning, we can make a display statement that says, you are a dork. Now, if you type it exactly like that, it's just going to say you're a dork. You're like, thanks. Now, what's kind of annoying about MATLAB is, say you type you are a dork, and then you forget to put that extra little thinky womper on it, apostrophe. It yells at you. And this is the thing, programming is, it does exactly what you tell it to do. So if I say you are a dork and I remember the shuppy-dop apostrophe but not the parenthesis, it yells at me again. Now, it does tell me why it's yelling at me in its own like super grown-up sophisticated way of telling me, like character vector is not terminated properly when calling a function or index. Like, thank you. Like, that totally, can't you just say you're missing a parenthesis? I mean, I guess it kind of says use parentheses or mismatched delimit. Why can't you just say you forgot your stupid parenthesis? And it does say, did you mean this? Which is, I guess, helpful, but why does it have to act like it's smarter than me? So anyway, while you're going through learning any programming language, 80% of the time that you're mad that it's not working, it's probably because you did something quote unquote stupid by forgetting a quote mark or forgetting a parenthesis or spelling something wrong. So for example, you know how x equals 2? Now if I say y equals x plus 3, well clearly y equals 5, but wait for this. Now if I accidentally said, well, z equals capital X plus 3, it's like, what are you talking about? I've never heard of X before. And you're like, I just capitalized it, stupid. And it's like, did you mean lowercase X? You're like, yes, dorkwad. And then it fixes it. But basically, if you've got a whole lot of bad language in your vocabulary, you're gonna make a great programmer. That's basically what constitutes a good programmer. So as you're going through this, you're gonna get really, really, really mad. And 80% of the time, it's gonna be something stupid, and that's the whole fun of it. And that's just the way it is. Okay, so this is MATLAB. It's pretty fantastic. Here's another one you can play with. Message box. You are just amazing. Weep, doop, doop, doop. And it just pops up a little message box. You are just amazing. So I know. Okay. So MATLAB can do all kinds of stuff. It has a built-in function called the surface plot and some pre-built-in data called peaks. If you type in surf peaks, it will pop up. Ooh, work directly with charts. I don't want to learn more right now. Ooh, drag to pan in 2D. Ooh. drag to rotate in 3D, scroll to zoom, maybe? No, it's, oh yeah. Zoomy, 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 zoomy. So you can make pretty plots in MATLAB and you can do stuff and in theory change color palettes. Oh, there's a thingy on there. All kinds of fancy. Ooh, I'm gonna brush the data. I don't even know what this means. But anyway, you can play with it. It's fun. You can do things. I don't really know why I would want to right now, but I'm just gonna align middles there. That didn't do anything. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, well anyway, you can apparently make these red. All right, so I'm gonna get out of that. All right, now I've got a bunch of stuff on here. It's amazing, but it's kind of distracting because there's all these angry things reminding me that I've screwed up. So I'm gonna type something that's going to make it all go away. Okay, so what I'm gonna type is CLC. I wish I could remember what CLC stood for. Don't remember. It's like clear, I don't know what it stands for. It's clear something or other. But notice what it's gonna do is it's only gonna clear this command window. Everything over here, all those variables still exist. It's just gonna clear this out so I don't feel so bad about myself. Okay, but notice that if I type in X, Y, and Z, all those things are still here. They still exist. But all the yucky, angry marks are gone. Something I kind of forgot to mention. So you know how whenever I was typing display and I forgot something? If you type the up arrow key, it will kind of pull things up so you can maybe not have to type all that up so much. Ooh, I have a lot of stuff up there. Okay. So let's see. What else can we do? All right. So another thing we can do, like if you're like, I'm done with all these and I actually don't want X to be 2 anymore, you can type clear. And that's actually going to clear everything in your workspace as well. And now it's all gone. So if I type X, it's going to be like, I don't know what X is anymore because you told me to forget. I'm like, okay. So CLC, and now it's like I've got a brand new open up MATLAB. So like, you know how they say close it and open it back up again? In MATLAB, you don't have to turn it off and turn it back on again. You can write CLC clear, and that's the equivalent of turning it off and turning it back on again. It's pretty fantastic. Okay. So obviously, typing everything in the command window is kind of silly because you have to type it perfectly the first time and to get it to work. And so I don't want to do that. So we're going to do something kind of cool called we're going to create a script. Now there's two different kinds of scripts. There's a script and there's a live script. And how about for the purposes of like, if I just wanted to make code and I was just going to like give it to somebody and I didn't care what they did with it, I would probably just do a script. So script by itself is just like code. So I could be like X equals 1 plus 2 and Y equals X plus 3. And notice I'm spacing things out kind of randomly. MATLAB doesn't care how I space things out. It's just gonna kind of do whatever. I can go over here and I can kind of type things out and decide how I want it. I can run the section and then it runs it down here. Now, this starts to annoy me that it separates things out so much. So I come in here and I type format compact and that gets rid of all these extra stupid entries. Okay. So I'm gonna run this again, run section. You can also hit, if you hover over it, it says control enter. So it's gonna go X equals 3, X equals 6. Okay, so if I was just gonna write code and send it to somebody, I could do that. If I was gonna write a program, I would probably send it to that, kind of write it in here and send it. Now, that said, since I'm gonna be kind of taking notes while I'm going through this, I'm gonna do something a little different. So I'll show you this and I'll show you how to save it. So you can save. And I'm gonna say blah, blah, blah. I can just call this, you know, stuff. And it's called stuff.m. Now I saved it. Now it's called C temp stuff. And I'm in the C temp folder. So I see stuff here. So this is kind of a silly thing, but you need to stop and triple track and make sure that all this looks right. Basically, if you see C temp stuff.m, and this says see temp, and this says stuff, and it's in black, then everything's right. Now, if you're like, well, I can see it, but I have to do like this, and it's in gray, you didn't do it right. Basically, this here needs to match, this here needs to match this, okay? MATLAB is like, it can only see what's in the working folder, and that's kind of a safety thing. It keeps you from screwing up your code in other folders. So, okay, so this is kind of like for plain boring code, and this is kind of an old school way to do it. But MATLAB recently came out with a new thing that I think is kind of cool, and I kind of want to transition to it. So I'm gonna learn, and you're gonna learn. It's gonna be fabulous. So this is stuff.m, and this is just code, and I can run it. And yeah, I'm just hitting Control Enter to do that. I'm gonna run. And I can run this code as much as I want, and I can even put in a display statement that says you are a bigger dork than I thought. Okay, so that's pretty fantastic. Now notice after I added something, it put a little star there. That means that I haven't saved it. So I can either hit Control S or click the Save button. Now it's saved again. All right, that was fantastic. I'm so glad we spent time doing that. Now, the other thing I'm going to do, so this is a .m file, and this might be something we need later, so I'm just letting you know it exists. So I'm going to pull up, oh yeah, it'll definitely be something we'll need later. But for the moment, I'm going to create a live script. Okay, this is a little bit funner. Now, see, this is MLX. So you know how like whenever Word stopped doing doc and it was like docx, and Excel stopped doing slx and it's like slxx. I think I got too many x's in there. But anyway, this is the new thing. Okay. So essentially what's going on, I didn't use it at first because I didn't know it had different kinds of layouts. But if you come over here on the left, there's going to be a thing that says output on right, output inline, and hide code. Immediately click output inline. Okay, so pshaw. And with that, we can kind of take this and stupid it down here. We don't really need it. Okay, so what's kind of cool about this is I can click between code and text. So what I can actually do is I can click text and I can keep notes. So I can be like, you know, these are my notes on how MATLAB works. And then I can be like, variables can have values in them, or something like that, because reasons. Okay, and then I can be like, okay, now I'm gonna enter some code. X equals 5. Y equals 2, Z equals X plus Y. And then I can run the section, and it runs it like do-do-do-do. So essentially, I can see each line of code and then what it does. So it's pretty cool. And I kind of like this because this way I can keep my notes, like if I'm trying to learn something, and then I can run the code, and then I can kind of see what happens. Does that make sense? So I think it's kind of fun. Okay, so this is kind of how I'm gonna put together all of this stuff going forward. And I think it's gonna be kind of neat, so let's go ahead and save this. So I'm gonna save this as my notes for today, okay? So I've got notes.mlx, and these are my notes for reasons. Now I can add a section. So there's a section break. So, and this will basically kind of break it out into pieces. So I can say, here are more notes. And you don't have to do headings. Here are. It's kind of neat, it kind of auto formats it for you. Variables can have values in them because reasons. You can override variable values if you want. So I can put in some code and I can say x equals 5, and then I can say x equals 5 or x plus 3 and see what that does. And I just, again, I hit Control Enter because I'm just used to doing that. But now I can see what the code does. So when I say x equals 5, it says x equals 5. And now it says x equals 8. Okay, so that's pretty cool because essentially, like if we saw x equals x plus 3 in math, we'd be like, well, that's bad because I could subtract x from both sides and I get 0 equals 3. But that's not what MATLAB does. It literally just overrides the previous value. So x used to be 5, and now x is 8. So if I go over here and I look at my workspace, x is now, in fact, 8. Kind of cool? Kind of cool. Kind of as a note, something that I like to do to not mess things up between sections, because you see how I still have the y's and the z's here? One of the things I like to do when I have a new section is go CLC, clear, and that clears out my variables from my previous, I guess I really don't technically need CLC, but it's just kind of a habit. It clears out my variables from my previous usage of MATLAB so that just in case, so I run this here and I have the X, Y, Z, and then if I come down here and I run it, it's just the X and the Y and the Z got cleared out so that if I use Y and Z again, like if I come down here and I try to say Y and run it, it's gonna say Y is not there because I cleared it and it doesn't exist anymore. So that's kind of a cool thing to be aware of. So this is pretty cool. You can override the variable values, just kind of a thing. But the important thing to note is that once I say that x equals 5 and then x equals x plus 3, that 5 is gone forever. You'll never, ever, 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 ever know what 5 used to be. Okay? Or what x used to be. You don't ever, ever know that it used to be 5. Just one of those things. Okay. Now, MATLAB is pretty straightforward. Couple of things that we could do. So you can override variable values if you want, but once you do, the old values are gone forever. So I'm putting like righty comments to myself here. Now you can put comments in your actual code if you wanted to. So you could do something like this, and I could put in a little percent sign. And that's a comment that the code doesn't read. And I can say, I'm using CLC clear to clear out all the old values of X, Y, and Z before I start afresh. I don't know why I decided to use the word afresh, but. So this is a comment that I've put in my code and it's in pretty good shape. And my phone is ringing. So I can run this, actually. Why am I doing that? There we go. And this is actually code. So if you wanted to put in a comment here, once I run this line, the 5 value that used to be x is lost forever. Lost forever. So sad. Okay, so MATLAB ignores the stuff that's in comments. I just wanted you to know you can write comments inside the code itself as well as writing comments outside. So anything that's in a text area, MATLAB's going to ignore. But if you're like, but I really, really want to make some kind of a note in the code itself, you can. You just have to put a little percent sign in front of it to make sure that MATLAB sees it. Okay. I think that's a good stopping point for a first thing. And then we'll do some more here in a little bit.